Hi, it's Julius, Head of Product for Pix4dFields. I will show you the accurate processing feature we introduced with Pix4dFields version 1.11. It is an additional processing option which allows you to generate highly detailed digital surface models. These are helpful for crop height analysis or to assess the topography of your fields. First, check that you are on version 1.11. If you are not a Fields user already, you can find a link in the video description for a free trial account. You can access the accurate processing option either from a new project or you can import a new dataset to an existing project. I will do it for an existing project where I can demonstrate the difference between the fast processing and the new accurate processing option. This project is a winter wheat research plot trial where different irrigation and fertilization treatments were evaluated. The dataset was collected with a DJI P4M UAV at 70 meters altitude with a mobile RTK correction signal for high positional accuracy. I already processed the dataset with the fast processing option. Now let's import the dataset again. I hit the import button on the top left corner with the import folder option. I select the folder where the images of the dataset reside. As the dataset has multispectral and RGB imagery, I am prompted to select which I want to process. For this demonstration, I will use the RGB images. Once the images are imported, you are presented with the processing menu, which we redesigned for version 1.11. The default is fast processing, and that's the option which you are already accustomed to since version 1 of Pix4dFields. It is blazing fast and produces high-resolution automosaics and coarse surface models. It is the best choice when you are in the field for scouting, general vegetation index analysis, or if you just need a really fast result. The new option is accurate processing. It is optimized to produce high-resolution surface models. Additionally, it can better handle challenging datasets with lots of elevation changes like rolling fields or steep slopes. It is also optimized for the geolocation of the outputs. This comes at the cost of increased processing time when compared to the fast processing option. It is best suited for non-time critical missions, for users who need high resolution surface data or the improved geolocation for spot applications and comparison between different flights. You can find more processing options in the advanced settings section, like full blending, radiometric correction, and GPU acceleration. If you encounter artifacts in your results, you can try to activate the full blending option. For more information about the different settings, please refer to our support article linked in the video description below. I will proceed with the accurate processing. Before you start the processing, please check on the preview that you imported the complete dataset and that it covers your intended area of interest and has no gaps. I will speed up the video now, and we see each other once the processing is finished. The processing is done, and we have the same dataset processed with fast and the accurate processing option. And I bet you want to see how those different results compare. So let's head right into it. The DSM created with accurate processing is really detailed, and you can see every single research plot on it. And this is not visual data, this is height data, as you can see on the legend below. If I switch now to the DSM created with fast processing, you can see no more details and only a really coarse trend of the field's topography. This is a compromise we have to make for the speed of the fast option. Let's see how the DSM compares against the simple vegetation index. I use the index calculator to generate a vary index layer, where red reflects high biomass and blue low biomass. With the compare mode, I can do a split view with the index on the left and the accurate DSM on the right. I like to show a close-up example of a non-fertilized plot and a highly fertilized plot. The blue area here was not fertilized and the red was fertilized. This demonstrates how powerful even simple RGB vegetation indices can sense differences in crop growth due to nitrogen deficiency. If you compare it with the accurate DSM, you can also see a difference in actual crop height due to the different fertilization treatments. So now you are not only able to assess the crop by vegetation indices, but also by crop height, and all with the same camera and dataset. That's awesome! But you cannot only inspect this visually, but also measure and export this information in Pix4D fields. For that, I use the annotation tool and place a point marker on the automosaic, because on the ortho I can clearly see the research plots. I place one marker in the middle of a plot and one beside on the dirt road, just to demonstrate the height differences between those two markers. Before we head over to the DSM layer, let's import also a geometry file with the button on the right sidebar. I prepared shapefiles for the non-fertilized control plots and for the fertilized treatment plots. I import both shapefiles, one after the other. I also set a color for the imported geometry. And now I do it again for the fertilized plots. My annotations are ready. Now I copy them from the ortho mosaic layer to the accurate DSM layer, with the copy all option on the right sidebar. I select the layer I want to copy and hit save. You can see on the left sidebar 4 annotations have been transferred to the accurate DSM layer. In the background, the statistics feature of Pix4D fields already kicked in and calculated the average height values for the annotations. First, let's have a look at the point markers, where we can see that the plot marker with 82.45 meters is higher than the road marker with 81.93 meters. Quick look again at the ortho for comparison. Now let's investigate the area annotations. We see that the average height for control plots is with 82.05 meters lower than the average height for the fertilized plots with 82.29 meters. The average is calculated from the height value of all DSM pixels intersecting with the area annotations. With the export menu on the top right corner, we can export those results as a convenient CSV file with the statistics option. Select the layer from which you want to export the statistics and hit export. This is a CSV file with mean height, height standard deviation, and area for our point and area annotations. The last thing I want to show you is the export to Pix4D Cloud, which not only allows easy sharing of the dataset, but also offers some interesting features like elevation profiles and volume calculations. We go again to the export menu and select Share. Configure which layers we want to upload to the cloud and also set the image scale. I am fine with 50% scale, so I can upload the data faster to the cloud. Don't forget to set a meaningful project name and hit upload. Once the upload is complete, you are presented with a Pix4D cloud link. You can open it in any web browser, be it on a desktop or mobile platform. And here is how the uploaded project looks on Pix4D cloud. With the DSM, the ortho mosaic, and the vegetation index layer. Let's look at the elevation profile feature. I create a line annotation along I want to see the elevation profile. I select Generate Elevation Profile on the right sidebar, and I'm presented with the elevation profile along the line. I can even position my cursor on the profile to track the position on the line. If you need to, you can export the profile as CSV. The second feature I want to demonstrate is the volume estimation based on the DSM layer. This time I import a shapefile through the annotation tool. It is an example for a non-fertilized control plot and a fertilized treatment plot. On the index layer, you can clearly see the difference in biomass between the two plots. Let me adjust the annotation colors of the two plots so they are easier to compare. You can now select the annotation and hit Convert to Volume in the top right corner. You are now able to generate estimations of volume for your annotations. For the control, it's 0.17 cubic meters. We do the same for the fertilized plot, and the volume is 1.45 cubic meters. This result was well expected according to the different treatments of the research trial. Let's wrap up here. I demonstrated that with the accurate processing option, we can now leverage accurate elevation data to compute height differences, elevation profiles, and volume estimations. All without extra effort and the same datasets we already had. If you want to know more about PIX4D-Field's accurate processing, check out the blog post and head over to our PIX4D-Field's community to get in touch with us and other PIX4D users. Both are linked in the video description. See you soon!